We have a 1,000-liter tank here that starts with 200 liters of water containing 10 grams per liter of some sort of dye. And we start pouring 20 liters per minute of pure water into the tank, and at the same time start draining 15 liters per minute out of the tank. And we assume that we have a big blender in the tank keeping it well mixed. This is a bit of a wild assumption, but it's the best we can do here. So what we're going to try to do is model Y of T, which is going to be the grams of dye in the tank after T minutes. And so we're going to look at first and see how are they changing. So we're going to look at rates in and rates out. Anything coming in could potentially increase the amount of dye in the tank, and anything leaving would decrease it. So we ask, what's coming into the tank? We got 20 liters per minute coming into the tank. But what units are we interested in here? dy dt, y measures grams of dye, t measures time in minutes. So this has units grams per minute. This is liters per minute. So to convert this from liters per minute to grams per minute, we need to multiply by how many grams per liter of dye are coming in. In this case, it's just pure water, so we have 0 grams per liter of dye coming in. Leaving, we have 15 liters per minute of liquid. And now we need to, again, multiply by the concentration of dye, grams per liter. Now, it's really tempting here to say it's 10, but it doesn't stay at 10, it starts at 10. And so, at any given time, how many grams of dye are in the tank? Well, that's what Y tells us. Y gives us the number of grams in the tank, out of how many liters. Well, we start with 200 liters, but notice that in this case, we have 20 liters per minute coming in, and only 15 liters per minute leaving, which means the amount of liquid in the tank is increasing by 5 liters each minute. And so after T minutes, the total number of liters in the tank would be the original 200 plus 5 for each minute that has gone by. Now, both of these now have that grams per minute unit, and so we are good to go. So, simplifying this down, we've got dy dt equals 20 times 0 is 0. Here, we have negative 15y over 200 plus 5t. That's my differential equation, and now we can look at initial condition. We know that at time 0, we started with 200 liters, 10 grams per liter, and so that is 200 liters times 10 grams per liter is 2,000 grams of dye at time 0. So there's the differential equation that we can solve to figure out how much dye is in the tank after T minutes. Now suppose that we wanted to know how much dye is there when the tank overflows. Because notice that because the volume is increasing in the tank, eventually this tank is going to overflow. So the first thing we might ask is, well, when is it going to overflow? So if it's starting out at 200 liters and increasing by 5 liters each minute, it'll overflow when there are 1,000 liters in the tank, and so that'll be when T is 40 minutes. So we need to know what is Y of 40, and in order to know that, we're going to need to solve the differential equation. And so let's clean up a little bit here and get ready to solve. So there's our differential equation. To solve this, we can start by separating. So we could divide both sides by y, and then multiply up the dt. And now we are ready to integrate, because now we are separated. So on the left, we're going to have ln y On the right side, we're going to need a substitution here. We're going to need to let u equal 200 plus 5t. So du will be 5 dt, and so this will become negative 15 over u du over 5. It simplifies down to, we can pull out that negative 3 after canceling, 1 over du. So we integrate negative 3 ln u, back substituting negative 3 ln 200 plus 5t. So this becomes negative 3 ln 200 plus 5t plus a constant. Great. So now we can exponentiate both sides to undo the ln on the left. So we get y equals e to the negative 3 ln 200 plus 5t. And I'm going to go ahead and break this apart here as multiplying e to the c, and then I'm going to end up calling this a new constant. So I got y equals some new constant, e to the minus 3 ln 200 plus 5t. Now, you may have noticed here, I have not canceled the e and the ln, and that's because I really can't with this negative 3 in the way here. So to handle that, we're going to have to use a log property, a log property that says that the log of a to the r is r log a. We're going to use this in reverse here to take this negative 3 and pop it up as the exponent. So we're going to write this as c2 e to the ln of 200 plus 5t to the negative 3, right? So we're going to pop that negative 3 up onto the a, so we're going to pop that negative 3 up as the exponent there. Now the e and the ln can undo each other, and we'll be left with 200 plus 5t to the negative 3. Now we can go ahead and use our initial condition. Y of 0 is 2,000, so we know y is 0 when t is, y is 2,000 when t is 0. So plugging in 0 for t, we get 200 to the negative 3. Solving there, we get a very large number. We get 1.6 times 10 to the 10th as the constant there. And then we were wanting y of 40. So y of 40 then will be, going back to our original equation, 1.6 times 10 to the 10th times 200 plus 5 times 40 to the negative 3rd. And that gives us 250 grams of dye in the tank when it overflows.